Why do humans get migraines? The potential answer is a real headache. Hey everyone, Matt Lieberman here for DNews. Just about everyone knows someone who's had a migraine, or if you're really unlucky, you suffer from them on a chronic basis. The Mayo Clinic defines a migraine as a headache that can cause intense throbbing or pulsing sensation in one area of the head and is commonly accompanied by nausea, vomiting, and extreme sensitivity to light and sound. They can last anywhere from minutes to several days in length, and the pain and disorientation can be so intense that it renders the sufferer incapable of doing just about anything. So why do we get them? There isn't one answer for sure, but a new study authored by researchers at the University of Toronto offers a compelling clue. Participants who witnessed physical abuse between their parents were more likely to get migraines. Men were 52% more likely and women were 64% more likely to get migraines if they had witnessed domestic violence as a child than those who hadn't. This means, potentially, that migraines are, at their core, caused by how the brain develops long before we reach adulthood. The headaches themselves are thought to be brought on by abnormal brain activity and an imbalance of serotonin in the brain. Now, serotonin is one of many neurotransmitters found in the human brain, and it's been proven that when under intense levels of stress and anxiety, the brain produces greater amounts of fear-related chemicals, such as adrenaline, and less of the chemicals associated with relaxation and joy, like serotonin. With this in mind, it's possible to build on the University of Toronto study and say that witnessing domestic physical violence raises the risk of migraines by adding viscerally stressful memories to a still developing mind. If the pattern of abuse is constant, the brain can very easily get used to overproducing adrenaline and underproducing serotonin. So, what can migraine sufferers do to avoid migraines? Avoid salty or overly processed foods, remain well hydrated, and avoid caffeine to start. Try to reduce stimulation. Bright lights and thumping bass are not your friends. Also, regular exercise can help release serotonin into the body, reducing anxiety and making migraines less likely. Now, we want to hear from you. Have you ever suffered from a migraine? How do you or your loved ones cope with them? Let us know down in the comments. Thanks for watching, and be sure to subscribe to DNews for new videos every single day of the week.